Over 30 years ago, one of the most controversial programming languages ever was released, PHP. To see what the hate is about, I went through the entire history of PHP and recreated the same application with every single version, and I was pleasantly surprised. Wait, PHP Tools 1. I mean, it wouldn't hurt to try it. All right, setup done. It works. Wow, this little counter at the bottom is doing that all by itself. Not bad. I mean, cool, handy little tool. Don't really see it going anywhere though. I mean, I'll stick with my enterprise Java. Thank you very much.
I'm having the baby.
It's back.
So it's a couple of years later since I started this video, and I see that PHP FI 2 has released. Interesting. Last month, we had Active Server Pages 2.0 released. I mean, that's what my boss wants me to use, but I'd rather support random developers that I talk to on message boards. Before you begin, if you have absolutely no Unix experience, you may want to ask around for someone with a little bit of Unix knowledge to help you through this installation. First of all, love the disclaimer that if you don't use Unix, then learn it. Interestingly enough, 3.0 is already announced and will be really different. Thankfully, an install script is here, and there's a lot of options here, and I mean a lot of options. It just won't stop, it seems. Okay, so I created the Apache module with it and created a simple guestbook application, and perfect. It works just fine, but let's make it a little bit pretty. Even better. Now, I have to admit, I am impressed with PHP 2. I like being able to include all of my code right there in the HTML. That way I don't have to write everything as a string in Perl. It just makes it that much easier. Even though the syntax looks like C a little bit, I still think it would be easier to use other programming languages like Perl instead of this. It also has built-in database access with MSQL. One thing that is tough though is that I still have to have hidden form fields to manage cookies. Now the great thing is that it's open source, while ASP looks the same, but requires me to have a Windows NT server license. No. I mean, why are we even talking about this? They said right there that they were gonna dramatically change this shortly, so let's see.
Change the way we think about personal computers.
Wait, PHP Hypertext Processor. Setup somewhat complicated, but okay. I was able to get the PHP info screen up. But the big change here is that this is kind of like a programming language now. It's no longer what feels like templates within an HTML document. Also, object-oriented support. Nice. It's like my enterprise Java, but with a dollar sign.
Hamburger Happy Meal.
So it's 2 years later. PHP 4 has been released and is powered by the Zend engine. Interesting. So the first thing I notice is how much faster this is in comparison. The new Zend engine, which makes it go really, really fast. But you do also have some awesome features, like built-in session support is one of them, and session management. Also some native XML parsing features as well, which thank God, I hate dealing with XML. I'm looking forward to seeing what comes next in the world of PHP. Oh, all right, it's been 4 years since PHP 4, and we finally have PHP 5. Never even thought it was gonna be that long, to be honest. And hey, new glasses. My wife said I looked like Jeffrey Dahmer. I was able to find this future technology that has made me extremely productive while using PHP. PHPStorm, I think it's called. It doesn't release for another 6 years, but they decided to sponsor this long video I'm making. It makes developing PHP applications super fast, like built-in Git support, database drivers to connect to all databases, and even future ones, and a debugger. You can also develop with JavaScript as well, so context switching is fast. There's just so much you can do with the JetBrains IDEs. I mean, at this rate, we might have something in the future, like a robot that writes code for us, but I mean, come on. I don't think that will happen for like 100 years at least. So first, the Zend engine is in version 2, which means it has a better garbage collector. Second, it now creates references rather than copies. Also, classic object-oriented features like class constructors, private variables, and abstract classes, exception handling, and a whole lot more. Wow. So let's just change our customer feedback tool / guestbook. This is a massive change. PHP is becoming a real programming language 10 years later. Now, there's a lot of WTFs with PHP 5. First is the inconsistent naming. String position, or strps, and str replace either have an underscore or doesn't. It's just inconsistent. Also, the callback parameters of some functions can sometimes be the first argument or the second. Variables would be automatically created from a get and post request, which I don't have to tell you why this is sus. That means PHP 6 is probably just right around the corner. So it's been 6 to 7 years and we're still on PHP 5. But in that time period, PHP has exploded in popularity. This little blogging project in 2003 is now powering the whole internet. WordPress. I'll bet $1 million that in 13 years, nothing crazy happens with WordPress. I got this email from Taylor. Check out Laravel, okay? A clean and classy PHP framework. So similar to existing frameworks like Ruby on Rails or Django, Laravel here seems to be trying to create an opinionated framework around PHP to make you build apps much faster. So routes, views, validation, ORMs, I mean, it seems pretty solid. So all we have to do is download the zip and then have our web server point to the specific location. Something I like is how easy it is to read everything. It's all nicely structured. At first, this whole expressive, eloquent, whatever sounded pretentious, but I kind of get it now, you know? Especially when you think about wrangling PHP into HTML. But where Laravel stands out, where all of these types of frameworks often do, is the ORM. So rather than writing out SQL statements, you define your tables in a PHP class and can query things similar to how it would look like in an array of objects, for example. This is great because you can get great syntax highlighting in PHPStorm. I always find it tough though, because you can't migrate anything within Laravel. It would be nice to manage my database, but maybe Taylor will add this in another version if this thing even takes off, I guess. Personally, it's a cool little side project, you know? I don't see it going anywhere though. So best of luck to you, Taylor, and I hope all the best. Oh, so I'm online and I hear that PHP 6 was released. Wait a minute. Must be an error? You're kidding. So what's changed? Well, performance has dramatically improved, almost doubling the speed. It reduced the memory usage, a new version of the Zend engine, return type declarations, error classes, spaceship operator, that's pretty cool, anonymous classes, and more. My boss wants me to refactor that old application. God, I gotta retire. What did we use again? Laravel? Is it still around? Version 5.2? Something that's also changed in the ecosystem is Composer, a package manager similar to, well, any package manager. This was way overdue. Something that also changed a ton too is JavaScript. I mean, I liked jQuery, but now you need single page applications in order to run a web application nowadays. In PHP Storm, I can easily upgrade my version to PHP 7 and we're off to the races. Laravel as a whole has completely changed. You can now manage your database with migrations completely, lots of security fixes, CLI tool, crazy change to the models, controllers, Blade, for your templates, which looks way better than the last thing that we did, and just a whole ton more. In PHP 7, we have this, which is awesome. We also have some pretty good quality of life improvements too, like this or this. I'm impressed. PHP 7 is pretty awesome, and Taylor, you did a good job, but sadly, PHP's reputation has gone down the drain, most likely from people having to fix old WordPress websites. But Laravel and PHP 7, on the other hand, it might change the way that we see PHP. We'll see. So it's been almost 10 years of doing this video. PHP 8 just dropped. It looks pretty awesome, actually. Union types to let you choose between several types. A just-in-time compiler so you can run your scripts fast. Enums. Wow. Never thought I'd see the day. Read-only properties and classes, random extension for better randomness, In PHP 8.4, one of the biggest updates is property hooks. It removes a lot of boilerplate from your set and get methods and lets you have a cleaner way of messing with data. Also, asymmetric property visibility lets you be more specific with visibility. So a shorthand way of saying you can get something but can't set. But best of all, the people love PHP now.
Everyone wants to say F tier for PHP, but PHP devs drive Lambos, so B tier.
PHP B tier? What an idiot.
So B tier.
All of a sudden, I feel less safe. You know, I feel like PHP is not quite B tier.
Finally, someone around here gets it. Wait, Laravel creator? Taylor was a dude this whole time? How is Laravel anyway? Version 11. Ecosystem? There's like 50 apps here. Wow, this blew up like crazy. Well, in 2024, PHP and Laravel has blown up. Influencers in the web ecosystem are everywhere talking about it. Let's see how it works with something a little bit more modern. What do people use nowadays? React, is that something people use? Laravel is really easy to set up with Composer. It even gives you common use cases with Breeze, which has Tailwind and authentication. Okay. There's also Jetstream, which is way more, I don't know. And to bring this into the modern world, there is Livewire, which lets you use Blade in the front end, but get that single page app functionality feeling. There's also Inertia, which is more of a bridge than a full-on framework where you still use React, Vue, whatever, but it just kind of bridges between the two frameworks. Something Laravel does really well is code generation. Using the Artisan console here, I can generate a new model, class, and more, and it can auto-migrate the needed fields in my database. With Inertia, you simply set up an Inertia app and make your app component a child of your Inertia function. And there's pros and cons to this. Obviously, you still use React to create applications, which, you know, great, depending on who you are. At the same time, a lot of the magic is happening over on the PHP side of things. So, for example, you route by returning Inertia views on the Laravel side of things. It's mostly something you need to get used to. Overall, after building my guestbook application, do people still use guestbooks nowadays? I don't know. I can say that I'm really impressed by the ecosystem that has developed around building this app. No lie, I probably finished this in like 2 to 3 hours, so props to you, Lambo dude. Is PHP good? I think so. For its intended purpose, it's a miracle that it was able to get to the level it went to, so yeah. With PHP Storm, it's really easy as well, since it just goes hand in hand with Laravel, especially if you use the Laravel IDEA plugin.